Hello and welcome to Andy's Little Sci-Fi Horror Show. My name's Andy. Tonight I'm accompanied by
Drew,
and we're out to get some tacos. I'm cruising the mean streets of.
Right now we're in.
Where are we?
We're in like Westboro. Yeah.
Westboro. You know you're hardcore when you have the directions tacked onto the front of your city.
Westboro, represent.
And we're talking about super hot, sexy comic book characters brought to life. On a screen.
Yes, on the screen. You go first.
Starting off with someone who I just watched today. I revisited Fantastic Four. Jessica Alba is Invisible Woman. She is ideal live-action comic book character. She did Dark Angel. She started with Dark Angel. James Cameron.
Yeah.
And then she moved on and she became Susan Storm, the Invisible Woman. I'm gonna take a moment and think of that cover. Okay, I'm done. I'm not usually that fast, so.
Exposure to a high-energy cosmic storm could advance our knowledge about planetary life.
To our future.
I don't trust him.
We got what we wanted.
Just worried about what he wants.
Physical structure is changing.
It's terrible news.
I think I'll get a second opinion.
The cloud has fundamentally altered our DNA.
That's gross.
Reed, look at me.
I can't.
You don't want to walk around on fire for the rest of your life, do you?
Is that a trick question? What if we got these powers for a reason?
I've always wanted power.
Well, you know, I'm a fan of Superman, so I'm gonna have to go with Supergirl.
The actress.
Oh, God.
Oh!
I don't know.
I stumped the man.
Come on.
Check the net.
So, another really good superhero that we didn't even talk about other than Supergirl is Batgirl.
Javon Craig. Oof. I've been DVRing all those reruns on the Hub. I got like 40-something plus episodes of the old classic Batman from the 1960s, and a lot more than I realized have Batgirl, the old Gidget Batgirl.
Yeah, don't go with the Alicia Silverstone.
Hey, Uncle Alfred.
Suit me up, Uncle Alfred.
Batgirl.
No, you had to go there. No, we're talking sexy.
I know, but I'm just saying people need to know.
Yes, we're not. It's I mean she.
Batgirl.
Yeah, she's pretty.
Six and a half.
She got nice eyes.
Personality.
Did I just say that?
You just said that.
All right, next, Wonder Woman.
Wonder Woman.
Ultimate pinnacle. I'm not even gonna go there. You know
Linda
what I mean.
Carter.
You know, Linda Carter. You know how I feel about her. And I'm looking forward to the upcoming Wonder Woman TV series. Looks interesting. I saw the sneak preview in the TV guide. Looks pretty good. I mean, Wonder Woman is one of these characters. I mean, I'm a huge fan. But I'm not one of these hardcore people that's gonna like forbid the new one, you know. I mean, I love the character. I love the animated movie versions.
So you're saying you like Wonder Woman. Okay, moving on. Another comic book character is Elektra.
Yes, Jennifer Gardner. Now, I just saw, in watching Fantastic Four, I watched the trailers on the DVD, and there's actually a trailer for Daredevil, and I forgot how unappealing she was in the Daredevil movie. They really, like, dulled her down. It was a terrible costume, a terrible rendition. They didn't give her character enough screen time. Thank God they did that movie, Elektra.
They just gave her, like, a quick thing, you know.
And then they killed her off. What the hell?
That was
well, actually, well, they had to do that because they were doing that part of the storyline of Daredevil.
Okay, moving on. There's Storm from X-Men.
Yes, probably the only tolerable Halle Berry. Okay. I'm not a big fan. She doesn't do anything for me. Which brings us to... I'll let you introduce this one.
Meow. Catwoman. Meow, meow, meow. I would say the best one, besides Julie Newmar...
Julie Newmar is always going to be number one.
Always going to be number one in my book. But if you have to go with a modern one, Michelle Pfeiffer.
Yeah, even though it's 20 years old, like, we can still call it modern. I see what you're saying, movie-wise.
Yeah.
I mean, you had Julie Newmar, Lee Merriweather, Eartha Kitt, Adrian Barbeau, Michelle Pfeiffer, and now Halle Berry. She's running out of lives.
Another comic book character, female action heroine.
The X-Men has a plethora of characters.
A very large plethora.
Yes. What comes to mind for me is Mystique.
Jean Grey.
Rogue. Yes. And yes, Storm.
Storm, of course.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are now seeing the beginnings of another stage of human evolution.
In every human being, there's not many people that'll understand people like us. There exists the genetic code.
You'll be safe here.
What kind of place is this?
You're not the only one with gifts.
For mutation.
The truth is, mutants are very real. When they are among us, we must know who they are, and above all, what they can do.
A change is coming.
Are you a God-fearing man, Senator?
And those we fear.
Magneto believes that a war is brewing between mutants and the rest of humanity.
Will be all that can save us.
If no one is equipped to oppose them, humanity's days could be over.
You're a mutant. The whole world out there is full of people that hate and fear you, and you're wasting your time trying to protect them? You sure you're on the right side?
I have made the first move. That is all I know.
He could wipe out everyone in New York City.
Logan, help us. Fight with us.
I'll take care of you.
We are the future, not them.
Settle this.
We're not what you think. Not all of us.
Back to the show. I gotta take a moment to bring up Birds of Prey. Barbara Gordon is the Oracle. The Huntress. Ashley Scott. And Diana, I wish they would have went a little bit more with it. You needed a second season. You needed a second season, and they gypped us out of it.
Oh, well. And I guess that would be all the sexy ladies brought to life that we're going to mention right now, because there's a lot more coming.
Well, we're going to wait for this to clear up.
Yeah.
Good night, folks.